quite a few years ago, when we were living in our old house, we had purchased a new house up the block and we were renovating it, the house that we currently live in. And rather than building a deck and then going out later for the next year and buying a sukkah, I figured I'm going to go to the local sukkah store, figure out what size sukkah I want, and then build the deck based on that. So I did that. I was very excited about it. And that night, I went to say goodnight to my daughters, who at the time were probably 10 and 8 years old, and sukkahs for that year was only a few days away. So I said to them, girls, this year we're going to be in our sukkah on our driveway outside our house. But next year, where are we going to be? Meaning, in our new sukkah, up the block? And they immediately, without any hesitation, said, in Yerushalayim, in Jerusalem. Of course. Because we say all the time, L'shana haba b'Yerushalayim, next year in Jerusalem. We don't say, next year up the block. So I felt like a fool. But I realized a number of years later that as ridiculous as it sounds and as accidental as it was, I may not have been totally off base. We all know how embassies work. They offer protection. Someone makes it inside the doors of an embassy, and the host country, typically due to treaties or agreements, won't go in to drag them out, to arrest them. They're protected. And in some rare instances, there's even extraterritoriality, where a person, a member of the diplomatic mission, or an item, the diplomatic pouch, may be considered as if that person or that object is actually in the country that owns the embassy, not in the host country where the person is standing at that moment or the pouch or package is. And some commentators say that's exactly how it works on the Sukkot holiday. No matter where you are in the world, you step inside a sukkah and it's as if you're in Israel. Now, I don't want to get a bunch of voicemails and texts and emails and WhatsApp messages and owls through my window asking me, how could you suggest that people don't have to go to Israel? I'm not suggesting that. Of course you should go to Israel. You should go for sukkahs. You should go any time throughout the year, early and often, whenever you can get there. Visit, and if you can, then live there. But if you can't make it to Israel for sukkahs, then at least consider that when you step into a sukkah, your own, your friends, your neighbors, you're stepping onto holy ground. It's like getting off the plane in Tel Aviv. That ground, even if it's the grass of your backyard or the wood or composite of your deck, it's holy land. Every second you spend out there, eating, drinking, talking, sleeping, chilling, is a mitzvah. Consider that and you'll elevate your holiday. You're standing inside God's protective embrace when you're in that sukkah. You're in the holy land.